There, Beam Team. Team Beam. Beam Squad. Dream Beam. Beam Dream. Look, it's like my 50th try at this, and I'm all out of ideas, but no matter what, I'm just super glad that you're here. Unless you've been living under a rock for the last year or so, you're probably familiar with ChatGPT. And at Beam Jobs, we're in the business of helping people find jobs. So for us, ChatGPT has been so helpful in helping write people's resumes and cover letters. I think a little bit lesser known, though, is that ChatGPT can be invaluable when you're preparing for your interviews. All you'll need is something to record yourself, phone, computer, that works. Access to ChatGPT, it's free, so we all have that. And the ability to watch yourself on camera, which to me is a deathly terrifying thought, but I promise we are gonna get through this together. So come along as we learn how to use ChatGPT to turn our interviews into more job offers. The trickiest part of interviews is thinking on your feet. The only way to get comfortable with it is to do it a lot and to practice, and that's where our good old friend ChatGPT comes in. We're gonna prompt ChatGPT to give us interview questions one at a time, and then we're gonna get the question, record our answers, break down our answers to those questions, and figure out how we can improve. It's a matter of just getting more and more practice. And don't worry if you mess up. That's why we practice, right? Feel free to use the prompt that I did for ChatGPT. Now, I asked for general interview questions, but you can definitely just ask for questions for your profession. So you can get marketing questions, software questions, HR questions, whatever kind of job you're looking for. All right, y'all, the reality is I've been delaying because I'm a few years out of practice on interview questions, but it's time to just give it a go, see what I got. For the sake of this exercise, I'm gonna pretend I'm applying to a marketing job at Beam Jobs. That's my company. Let's get started and tackle our first question. Let's prompt ChatGPT with little next. Haven't seen this one before, so let's see what happens. Can you describe a challenging situation you faced at work and how you handled it? Why, yes I can. And might I say that you are a beautiful interviewer. Okay, so back in my first job out of college when I was working at Geico, I was tasked with customer retention. So my job was to make sure that customers stayed with Geico longer. And one of the ways we would do that is I would pull in data to see who was most vulnerable to cancel. Unfortunately, one time when I tried to pull data using something called SQL, I crashed a server. I was 1 year out of college and I thought I would never work again. But luckily, my boss was super understanding. And what I learned is that if you're unsure about something, it's so much better just to ask than to plot ahead, especially when you're dealing with millions and millions and millions and millions of data points. My rating of that answer, let's go with a 3 out of 5. What is the interview looking for here with this question? They want to know, 1, are you self-aware enough to know that you're capable of making mistakes? 2, can you identify when you make those mistakes? And 3, what do you learn from your mistakes so you don't make those mistakes again? I think I did a really good job of identifying the mistake, but what I fell short on was trying to apply what I learned from that mistake to other points in my career. So tangibly, you really want to also hammer home what you learned from that mistake and how you actually applied it for your future jobs. On to the next. On to the next one. Next. All right. Oof. What are your strengths and weaknesses as they relate to this position? Well, first, I'll start with my strengths. I think I'm really good at working in a super small startup. I know your team is less than 5 people, and what I've done historically in my career is I take ownership. For example, at my time at Chegg, I was tasked with how we can evaluate the efficacy of our SEO marketing efforts. So I came up with a unique logistic regression model to determine which keywords were most likely to drive conversions and which keywords we were most likely to increase rankings for, to get more people to the site, to get more customers. Now, my weaknesses, I specifically early in my career can be dependent a little on team members for areas of uncertainty. So while I'm really good at ownership, sometimes I struggled in the past with trying to solve for things that I've never seen before. 1 out of 5, I don't care what the scale is. 1 out of 100, it's a 1. Why is it a 1? The strengths were fine. The strengths are always easy to talk about. And you've always heard on the weaknesses side of things, try to turn your weakness into a strength. I don't think that's real. You should really talk about your weaknesses, but make sure your weakness isn't the biggest red flag that they're looking for, right? In this instance, I'm applying to a job at a startup. The one thing they want is that they don't want you to rely on others when you don't know how to answer a problem. Instead, I could have said something like, one of my weaknesses is working with a lot of bureaucracy. A small startup is not gonna have a lot of bureaucracy. On to the next one. How do you stay updated on industry trends and changes? Well, thank you for the question. It's a wonderful question indeed. Again, don't say that. For me, I really try to stay on top of marketing trends. I'm a big advocate of Reddit, and specifically certain subreddits around search engine optimization and marketing. I stay on the cutting edge, and I get to participate in community and learn from others who are in a similar spot from me. It's a hobby of mine, right? It's not just my work. I really just enjoy reading about this stuff and learning more and trying to stay on top of my game. You done good, kid. You done good. I'm gonna say that's a solid 5 out of 5. I thought I really nailed that one. What are they looking for in this question? In this question, they just wanna make sure that you are taking an active interest in your career and your profession and really going out of your way to learn more and stay on top of trends, right? If you're active in a community, or you're actively subscribing to newsletters and reading those newsletters, you're solving that question. So always try to ask, what are they really trying to look for in this answer? And then get after that. Next! How do you handle feedback, and can you provide an example of a time when you use feedback to improve your performance? At work, I try to be egoless, right? I don't think my ideas are more valuable inherently than anyone else's ideas. And I also try to take that lens when it comes to feedback. I actively solicit it. I ask colleagues, I ask my boss, I ask my boss's boss, how can I improve? How can I get better? And specifically, one way that I improved in this is I had to send these daily recap emails of marketing initiatives and how they were driving new customers every single day. And my boss told me I was getting too in the weeds, right? I needed to actually offer opinions, not just data, 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 data. That's exactly what I started doing. So I started including a summary at the top of all of those emails with my specific opinion about what the data meant, not just inundating people with information and letting them decide it. I gave an opinion, I made my voice heard, and that's something I take into my next job. I gotta go with a 3 out of 5. I think the substance of my answer was good, but I just stumbled a lot. So when you're in those situations, take a breath, slow down. It's okay to slow down. Now, with this question, you just wanna make sure that you have very specific instances of when you got feedback, and then how you executed that feedback. That's something you should go armed with to any interview before you start it. Understand times you've messed up, understand times you've gotten feedback, and then just really focus on how you took that feedback and ran with it. Just make sure you're open to feedback. It's all your boss wants. It's all these hiring managers want to hear. I know what you're probably thinking. Wow, we lived, we laughed, we loved, and we learned. Anyway, that's how you can use ChatGPT to help you prepare for interviews. It's just practice. It's more practice equals perfection, and that's true when you're looking for a job. You don't necessarily want to run before you can walk. So in the next video, we'll show you how to build your resume so you can make sure you get the interview. And then from here on out, you can nail the interview to get your next job. Thanks so much. Have a good one.